All right, then. Ivan brought his hands above his head, elevating the cries of his devotees as he masked his face with his voluminous sleeves, deftly switching his mirrored aviator shades with an identical pair of welding goggles he'd attached to his forearm and hidden up his sleeve. Then he pressed a trigger button on a small remote strapped to his other wrist and brought his fingers into a perfect Gyan Mudra, touching his forefingers to his thumbs and settling the backs of his hands upon his knees. 5 seconds on the fuse, Om Mani Padme Hum. And though Ivan could scarcely see anything through his welding goggles, he certainly saw the sizzling flash of white flare all around the table and amidst a chorus of cries of exultation. And knowing nobody could see anything but the blinding white light, he slid off the table and slipped out of his turban and robe, leaving them with the original aviator shades he'd been wearing in a pile upon the altar to make it seem as if he'd dematerialized right out of his clothing. He'd dressed for the stealth of it in a black outfit beneath his robe and ducked beneath the heavy cloth shrouding the table. There, he removed his welder's goggles and readied his escape. Ivan had left the manhole cover slightly ajar from its lip 2 nights before. This had required a special hook to remove the 100-pound plate, and now he pulled on some gloves, slid the hook out of his belt, dragged the manhole cover 2/3 off, and crawled down the ladder, scanning around once more to make sure he hadn't left anything behind. And satisfied that the magnesium fuses he'd rigged throughout all the flame-retardant roses were still flaring spectacularly bright, he slipped on a headlamp and made his way down the ladder into a utility tunnel, pausing only to lock the manhole cover back into its position with his hook. Then, it was about a half a mile through a network of underground tunnels before Ivan fit a dark wig over his own thinning blonde hair and fixed a phony mustache in place, climbed another ladder, opened another manhole beneath the rear bumper of his Range Rover he'd parked early that morning on a nearby residential side street, and, having previously raised the vehicle's suspension to its extended profile option, squirmed out easily, replaced the manhole cover, retrieved the keys from a magnetic key locker behind the rear bumper, checked his reflection in the tinted rear window of his Range Rover, and chuckled at his own magnificence.